Hola a todos, yo soy Miko Hatsume-sama y en este video van a ver una entrevista que le voy a hacer a la cabeza, o cómo decirlo, el líder, escritor de la página Miko Fan. So, los voy a introducir, yo voy a, él va a estar hablando en inglés, yo les voy a estar traduciendo. I'm telling them like who you are and I'm going to be translating everything, sorry for my voice.
Okay.
Okay, so in small phrases so that I can translate. Try to introduce yourself because many people just don't know what Miku Fan is.
Miku Fan is the number one ranked Miku fan site in the world in terms of visitor fan traffic from fans around the world. And I also help promote Vocaloid musicians to a worldwide audience on the side.
Okay. Él dice de que la página de Miku Fan es la número uno en cuanto a visitantes. Como tráfico de visitantes en la página, aparte de también ser como un productor, ya que también ayuda a los productores de música y todo lo demás. Okay. What do you think about Miku going to Mexico?
I think it's actually great. I'm pretty aware of the massive fan base that Hatsune Miku has in Mexico, so I'm really glad that the fans down there actually get a chance to experience an event for themselves. I really think they should get the opportunity to experience that just like anyone else in the world should, so I'm very happy for them.
Okay. En cortas palabras, él dice de que está bastante impresionado acerca de la masiva cantidad de fans que tiene Miku en México y de que es una experiencia que ellos deberían vivir, que es algo que no deberían perder. Que se siente bastante feliz por ustedes. Okay, so there are tons of websites with a lot of rules for like for Miku concerts. What are like the basic rules for these concerts? ¿Cuáles son las reglas básicas? Ya que hay muchas páginas web que tienen toneladas de información y toneladas de reglas, pero le estoy preguntando a él cuáles son como las básicas. So what would be like the first one, the number one?
Pretty much just respect everyone else, you know. No pushing, shoving, you know, causing fights with anyone or anything. You know, we're all fans there to have fun together. So make the most of it. This time around they are allowing some limited amounts of video and photography, but they will ask you to keep your flash off and be respectful and don't think it's okay to record the entire concert because of it. Remember, there are other people trying to enjoy watching it, so it may be a distraction. And,
I'll translate this first. Okay. Él dice que el número uno sería respetar. Respetar porque somos todos fans y no hay que estar como empujando a la gente, como estar tratándolos mal en medio del concierto. También menciona que por esta vez Miku Expo ha permitido grabar cierta cantidad de video, como unos cuantos segundos, unos cuantos minutos, más sin embargo no todo el concierto. También puedes tomar fotos, pero obviamente todo esto sin flash.
I think that's actually pretty much everything I wanted to say.
Really?
Yeah.
That is like the most basic rules.
Yeah,
what about the lighting? They have the, like, should they just do whatever they want or they just like follow the other people who's trying to buy them?
There will very likely be more experienced fans more towards the front of the crowd when it comes to these Miku concerts. Those are going to be the lead. So those are going to be the people you follow for the event.
Okay, yo le pregunté que si las personas deberían cuando van al concierto hacer lo que quieran con sus luces, porque como bien saben, en el momento del Miku, de la Miku Expo siempre les van a dar como un pequeño glow stick gratis, the free glow stick, so everyone can like participate in that, you know.
And it's a good idea not to activate those until right when the concert starts. They do not last long.
Yeah, that's true. Entonces, como les estaba diciendo, él dice que lo mejor es como dejarse guiar por la gente que está al frente. Generalmente la gente que está al frente del concierto son las personas que tienen más experiencia. No estoy diciendo como que los mexicanos que van al frente, sino las personas que están viajando hasta México para poderlos guiar a ustedes. Entonces, si ellos están tratando como de guiarlos con el ritmo de las luces, intenten seguirlos a ellos porque se disfruta más. Like, you enjoy even more when you are doing just like the same that they are trying to.
It's a lot more fun when you're going with everyone else.
Exactly, and it looks beautiful.
It does.
Se ve hermoso, es como cuando uno ve un video en YouTube que se ve divino, se ven las luces y se siente muy bien ser parte de esa experiencia. Lo otro que él dice es de que apenas entren al concierto, no quiebren, no lo quiebren, like, el neón, no lo quiebren en ese momento, porque solamente dura 2 horas. Y el concierto, how long is the concert? Like 3 hours?
Almost 3 hours.
Es casi 3 horas. Y para el momento en que ya es como lo último, en cuando estás haciendo como el encore, encore, tú, like when is the encore moment, you're not going to have a glow stick, right?
It's about that time they're going dead.
Yeah. Mucha gente en el encore ya tiene como el glow stick amarillo. They have like the glow stick, like yellow glow stick, like Kagamine glow stick, not green anymore.
Yeah.
Tiene como el glow stick amarillo porque se les acaba. Sencillamente mucha gente no sabe eso y por eso se lo estamos advirtiendo. What do you think about the not official merchandise that is going to be so very close to the venue of the concert in Mexico?
It's not something I approve of, or most Miku fans in general approve of. I consider it almost taking advantage of unaware Miku fans that may not realize. That sort of thing is generally frowned upon. It's morally not correct. I mean, they are going to be selling official merchandise there, so if you want to do your best to actually show your appreciation and your support for these events in Mexico, please don't spend your money on the bootleg unofficial merchandise. Give it to the people that are actually bringing this event to you. They deserve it. So that's my opinion.
Yeah, also that's the way, like, you support, like, that the concert is going there, like, you're supporting the people that's going there.
Mm-hmm.
When you buy that merchandise, it's not just like, because, like, many people think that it's expensive. Why do you think that it's expensive, like, the merchandise?
Well, official goods are made in higher quality versus the bootleg products.
Exactly.
So,
él está diciendo que, yo le pregunté acerca de que, ¿qué opinaba él acerca de la mercancía que es vendida, al, que va a ser vendida como alrededor, cerca de la zona del concierto? ¿Qué él opina de las cosas que no son oficiales? Y él dice que definitivamente, moralmente, no está bien. Hay que intentar comprar las cosas que son licenciadas, right? It's better to buy something that is already licensed by Krypton and all that stuff. Es mejor comprar las cosas que ya son licenciadas por Krypton para mostrar el apoyo a las personas que están llevando ese concierto a ustedes, porque the people who's selling the bootlegs, they are no one in this industry for Vocaloid. Like, if you're supporting just bootlegs, you're not going to get, like, Miku back, probably.
No.
Yeah. Si ustedes apoyan a la gente que vende bootlegs, they just care about their selves, right?
They're just people trying to make money for themselves. Nothing is going to support anyone.
Not even the authors, the personal illustrations or the producers of the music, like when they sell pirates CDs and all
that
stuff.
Yeah, before you buy bootlegs, think about the people that bring you everything you enjoy. The illustrators, the musicians, the video creators, the concert creators, the band, and Krypton, who also, you know, just created all a lot of the Vocaloids we know. Not all of them, my apologies. Just kind of think about that before you decide supporting bootlegs.
Porque las personas que venden bootlegs solamente se preocupan por ellas mismas, no se preocupan por otra cosa, solamente quieren vender cosas, solamente se preocupan por ellos. Ese dinero no apoya a los artistas que nos gustan, no apoyan las ilustraciones que nos gustan, que donde Miku se ve bien, no apoya a los productores. Por ejemplo, yo sé, porque yo soy latinoamericana, que en Latinoamérica hay muchas cosas piratas, muchísimas, CDs piratas, DVDs piratas, y eso simplemente no está bien. Las cosas son caras, porque tienen licencias de Krypton, tienen licencias de otras compañías que apoyan a Miku a ir alrededor del mundo para llegar a muchos más conciertos. This year though, she's hitting 10 cities.
And a lot of buzz got around after Miku Expo in 2014. So what happened was originally it was going to be just a few cities, and then concert promoters in other cities in the U.S. started hearing about it and say, we want in on this. Oh. And then they also approached Krypton with offers. That's why cities like Houston, Mexico City, and, or I think it was Monterrey, I'm sorry, I can't remember which came
it's
second.
Monterrey and Mexico City, both of them, yeah.
Yeah, the one that came second in Mexico all suddenly got announced later because got more
the
offers.
The Monterrey, yeah.
Yeah. So that's what needs to happen, and that's also kind of why it hasn't happened in Europe yet. They haven't had offers from Europe yet.
I see. Okay, so él dice de que eso fue lo que yo le dije a él en este tour. Miku está va a ir a 10 ciudades. Entonces él dice de que es porque solamente iba a ir a ciertas ciudades, pero la gente empezó a escuchar acerca de él y dijeron queremos ser parte de esto, queremos que Miku venga. El cual fue el caso de Houston, la Ciudad de México, y Monterrey, pero Monterrey ya fue porque México fue completamente sold out. In just a few minutes it was completely sold out, like Mexico City.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah, fue totalmente sold out en unos minutos. VIP, General Admission, todo se fue. Fue genial. There's a lot of people who's complaining because Monterrey is going to be first instead of Mexico City. They are just like, they don't get it.
Even though it's announced later and it's coming before, that's just the dates that happen to be agreed upon by, again, the concert promoters that approached Krypton with the offer, and Krypton agreed. And scheduling-wise, it was probably the only thing they could work out for that venue. Other dates may have been booked by other performances already.
Because people, they just forget that the concert venue is not just for Miku, it's for many other artists.
Exactly. So it's not like it's empty the entire year and then suddenly Miku appears.
Exactly. They are not like empty the whole year.
It was probably one of the few available time slots that they could work out in the time frame the North America tour is happening. Anything else may have been too late or too early.
Exactly. Entonces, lo que estamos hablando aquí es de que mucha gente estuvo... Yo leí muchos comentarios donde la gente estuvo armando problema que porque Monterrey va primero, viendo que sus ventas fueron después, que hubo gente que va a ir desde Monterrey hasta Ciudad de México porque ahí es donde tiene el boleto, etc. Primero Monterrey fue gracias al sold out de México. Monterrey was because of the sold out in Mexico City. That's true.
Yeah, it sold out so fast they realized they should
make another one, and that one got sold out as well. So they needed another venue, I guess, I don't know.
That was actually where they got another offer again.
Oh, I see.
News of the first one selling out so fast got around to other venues, and they got an offer from Monterrey. So Monterrey.
If they wouldn't got that offer, Mexico would be those just the two events, and that's it, right? Not Monterrey.
Correct.
Yeah. Just so dying. So I'm sorry for the other people who couldn't get it. Right.
So yeah, they got another offer. They quickly checked what available time slots they had that was, again, within the time frame because they're finishing this tour within a matter of a couple of months in North America, and it was probably the only date they could work out. So it's nothing against Mexico City fans. It's just scheduling from both parties on both sides. That's just what worked.
En sí, mucha gente no entiende de que Monterrey vino después porque Mexico City fue completamente sold out. Sí, luego después de que abrieron la segunda también fue sold out. Después de esa fue que Monterrey contactó a Krypton y dijo queremos ser parte de esto y le dijeron nosotros tenemos disponible este tiempo, les funciona, y pues ese tiempo fue antes del concierto de Mexico City. Por eso es de que primero es Monterrey, porque los sitios donde va a ir Miku son sitios de conciertos, no es o puede ser bueno Plaza La Condesa o cosas así, pero ellos tienen un horario, no es como que ellos estén libres todo el tiempo. Simplemente Monterrey tuvo tiempo antes que México. Tal vez México no lo pudo hacer antes. Ese es el problema, la gente simplemente no lo entiende. Le pregunté a él de que si Krypton no hubiera tenido la propuesta de Monterrey, México City solamente hubiera tenido sus dos conciertos y lo siento mucho por la gente que no pudo tener boleto, porque solamente eran esos dos, no se podía hacer nada más. O sea, den gracias de que también va a ir a Monterrey. También dijo unos minutos antes que no se ha escuchado propuestas en Europa. There's like no offers in Europe, but none of the offers has worked out. Or...
From what I understand, currently no known offers from Europe.
Nothing.
Not that I've heard.
Okay. De lo que él haya escuchado, no hay ofertas para Miku en Europa. No hay. Okay. Some of my followers, they made some questions.
Okay.
And I'm going to try to read some of them. Also, from the questions that I'm going to make you, I would like you to choose one, because I want to give a gift in my channel.
Okay.
Okay? Mm-hmm. And I ask them to make questions about Miku Expo, not just about Miku.
Okay.
So, not all the people is going to participate, just a few
some of the questions, yeah.
Entonces le estoy diciendo de que mis seguidores en el canal hicieron algunas preguntas y les dije de que yo pedí preguntas relacionadas a Miku Expo, no relacionadas a Miku. Así que no toda la gente que mandó preguntas puede participar. Así que el ganador se va a elegir de una vez. Yo iba a pedir de que compartieran el video porque es algo importante de saber, porque hay mucha gente que simplemente quiere dar problemas y no está bien, como que hablan cosas de Miku y no me agrada, por eso quería como traer a alguien que supiera mucho de Miku y él es la persona correcta. Quería traer una persona que pudiera hablar a través de mí para que ustedes se dieran, bueno, a través de mí, para que ustedes pudieran entender que no son ideas locas de Miku-sama, sino que es una realidad, de que no cámaras, no flash, seguir las luces, no bootlegs. There's people who think that bootlegs is just figures.
No, bootlegs can be any kind of unofficial merchandise. It can be shirts, socks, shoes, any kind of apparel. It can be posters, it can also, yes, be figures, it can be plushies. It's basically anything that is not licensed by the company that owns the rights to that character.
And there's other people who don't understand the difference between bootlegs and not an original, I say, like an original product. Like if you draw something by yourself and you want to sell it, that's fine, because...
That can be difficult for sure, but for people that don't know how to research that sort of thing. At the very least, an easy way to spot official Miku merchandise is, usually the official merchandise will always have a copyright Krypton Future Media, as well as copyright PiaPro.net text on it. So that's a way to spot an official, because bootlegs will not have that.
And some of them also have current.
Yes, there's also copyright guarantee if it's an officially licensed Krypton album item.
Yeah. Me estaba diciendo de que mucha gente piensa que los bootlegs son solamente figuras y en realidad no. Hay ropa, hay peluches, hay posters, todo lo que no sea licenciado, todo lo que sea tomado de internet, algo como una imagen que guste mucho, por ejemplo, de Kay, que es el dibujante de la B3 y todo eso, tomas ese dibujo y luego vendes un póster que no es tuyo, que no es tu ilustración, eso es un bootleg. Y ahora, si tú pintas algo por ti mismo y lo quieres vender, es difícil, pero lo puedes hacer porque es algo original, es algo tuyo, es de tu propiedad. Así que hay una diferencia entre como trabajo original y bootlegs. Okay, the first question says, at Miku Expo, is it possible to have a kind of relationship with Hiroyuki Ito?
You may see him wandering around, and if you do, it's certainly okay to say hi. Maybe even make the offer to, shake his hand. And usually he's kind enough to allow people to take photos with him. But obviously don't try to overwhelm the guy. You know, Krypton, the staff they do have here, they are usually relatively busy. But they are usually kind enough to take a little time to say hi and mingle with the fans a little bit. and it will be their first time having an event in Mexico, so I'm sure they will be very interested in visiting with the crowd there.
It would be awesome to know that before, because when I saw Hiroyuki Ito, I wasn't sure about shaking his hand, because I know shaking his hand, like shaking hands, is not good seen in Japan, right? You should just like do like this.
But I think he knows true. That he's American. They do understand the cultural differences, so I think that would be forgiven. But definitely maybe just a little bow or something as a greeting would probably be better as well.
Okay. Yo le hay una pregunta aquí hecha por... No tengo todavía... Bueno, yo tengo el nombre guardado. Pero decía de que si pueden tener algún tipo de interacción con Hiroyuki Ito. Hiroyuki Ito es como el papá de Miku, es el dueño. Y pues lo van a ver alrededor de los conciertos, va a ir caminando muy tranquilamente. Pueden acercarse con mucho respeto, very respectful, like you have to go there very respectfully say hello, not just like go and take a selfie with him, you know.
Yeah, and keep in mind the staff, not a lot of the Krypton staff, if maybe any, understand Spanish, so if you know
not even
at
English.
Least...
Not even English.
No, he understands English.
He understands English, but like, I'm talking like the staff, not all the staff understands English either.
But simple, just hello, you know, and everything can go pretty well if they can at least say that.
Yeah. Si ustedes pueden decir al menos hello, no intenten hablarlo como en español porque no creo que lo entienda. Pero si ustedes se acercan respetuosamente, ustedes pueden como saludarlo de mano, él va a entender la cultura de nosotros, de que nosotros saludamos de mano. No se vayan a tirar encima de él a pedir una selfie, por favor. Es una persona muy ocupada y es bastante seria, así que con mucho respeto. También le decía desde que me hubiera gustado haber sabido ser que yo podía sacudir la mano, porque yo me encontré con Hiroyuki Ito en el Miku Expo Digital Stars Event. Y lo vi allá y no sabía, yo estaba como sin saber qué hacer, como lo saludo, no lo saludo, ¿qué hago? ¿Hago reverencia? No sabía qué hacer, la verdad. I was telling them that I had no idea what to do. I was like, you know, you can't do this in front of me, what should I do? That was so funny. Okay, let's go to the other one. Why do you think that Miku is not going to every single country in the world?
Logistically and financially, it's impossible. Krypton is a very small company. People often confuse them for a big company. I did visit their office. They occupy basically half of a floor of a building in Sapporo. So that being said, that their available crew is very small, and the amount of crew they can hire is very small. What they require to make an event happen in an area is they will need support from the local promoters, the concert promoters for venues in those areas. They make an offer to Krypton saying, hey, we think it would be great to bring Miku here. They work out a deal with Krypton, and then the concert gets greenlit if everything goes well.
Yo le pregunté que por qué cree que Miku no llega a todos los países. Él dice que Krypton en realidad es una empresa pequeña. Mucha gente piensa que es una empresa grande. Él fue a la oficina de Krypton y él solamente ocupaba como un cuarto, half or a quarter of the floor.
Half of the floor now.
Okay. La mitad del piso de un edificio. O sea, no es grande. Ellos solamente pueden contratar a cierta cantidad de gente. Y lo que más necesita Krypton es apoyo, support. That's the most important thing, support from the place where the concert is going to be made. Yeah. Necesitan apoyo de la gente donde el concierto va a ser hecho. Como, hey, queremos que ustedes vengan, nosotros vamos a arreglar las cosas y así. Por eso es de que Miku va casi siempre a Los Ángeles y a Nueva York, porque allá tiene apoyo. The interaction between the band, Miku, and the public. How is it at Miku Expo?
The interaction between the band, Miku, and the public?
Yeah.
I don't quite understand the context of that question.
I think they mean like when they're making the band introduction, like how the public react to the band, or they just care about Miku. I think it depends on the person, because some people, they just go for Miku and they are just...
There will be probably some people in the audience that will be there to care just for Miku. And there will be people there that will also appreciate the band's part and role in that. I mean, keep in mind what this would sound like if it was just Miku singing and no instruments. It wouldn't be very fun.
Because the music band, is life yeah, music, yeah.
The band is a very important part of the concert, so when the band introduction does come around, definitely pay your respects and give them a little cheer because they deserve it.
They do, absolutely. Le dije yo que cuál era como la interacción entre la banda, Miku y el público. Él me dijo, no entiendo muy bien lo que me estás diciendo. Entonces le dije yo, tal vez en el momento de la introducción de la banda, el público interactúa bien con la banda, con Miku. Alguna gente simplemente le interesa a Miku, no les interesa la banda. Entonces él dice, ellos merecen que los animen y los aplaudan, porque qué sería como de Miku Expo con Miku solamente cantando y no banda, no sería bien. Porque la gente no sabe o no piensa de que la música es en vivo. La música es en vivo, no es una grabación. Usted siente cuando le están dando duro ese platillo y usted lo ve, es increíble. Me encanta. When they see on YouTube videos, they see like the band is trying to say hi to the public and all that stuff, but that is also part of the band introduction. That is the only moment that they try to like interact with the public, right?
Yeah, the band intro, which happens kind of like 2/3 of the way through the concert, that's, you know, when each individual band member kind of gets the spotlight and, you know, shows off their instrument and things like that. Other than that, there isn't like any major focus on the band members throughout the concert. It is primarily focused on the vocal lady that is currently performing on stage. So don't think that, you know, attention's being yanked away from your favorite characters. They do get their moment, but like I said, they deserve it.
Hubo una persona diciendo de que en algunos videos de YouTube se veía a la banda tratando de interactuar con el público, como diciéndoles hola y así, que si eso era verdad. Sí, eso es en el momento de la introducción de la banda, donde simplemente ellos tocan su solo y muestran sus capacidades y todo eso. Pero es como el único momento, porque en realidad el concierto está enfocado en los Vocaloids, no tanto en la banda, pero igual ellos merecen su reconocimiento. How can we show like a lot of respect to the Krypton stuff and the band and Miku as well? I think the very respectful way would be like the first rule that we get, right?
Yeah, just be kind and courteous to everyone, really. I don't really know what to say beyond that.
I think they're saying this because in Japan, they don't know like how is the Japanese culture. They don't know if they should scream in the concert. They don't know if they should clap in the concert. They don't know if, you know.
There will be times in some songs where you may see the actual character on screen clapping. And in other words, that's an okay time to clap as well. When the character's waving, that's when you wave. You follow the hand of that character. Cheering at the same time as everyone else is also good. If you're suddenly the only person screaming, you kind of become a distraction for other people also trying to enjoy the concert, so.
Okay, le estaba preguntando acerca de cómo mostrar mayor respeto a Krypton, la banda y todo eso. En sí, si vamos enfocados a esa pregunta, sería la primera regla, tratar de ser un buen fan, respetar, etcétera. Ahora, si se trata como de cómo comportarse en el evento, si puedes gritar, si puedes aplaudir, en sí, algunas veces el Vocaloid va a estar como haciendo movimiento como de aplaudir. Ahí es cuando tú aplaudes o cruzas las luces, o cuando está como haciendo la ola y así, es cuando tú empiezas como a hacer la ola también. Entonces, hay un momento para todo, también para los gritos. Hay momentos en que puedes gritar y hay momentos en que no puedes gritar. Porque si todo está en silencio, si tú gritas, se va a escuchar completamente y puede que arruines el momento para algunas personas. Entonces es mejor como gritar junto a las demás personas en vez de gritar solo por ti mismo. Piensa de que el concierto no es solo para ti, es para todos los demás. How is gonna be the sales at Miku Expo? Is like entering to a Miku store, or going to be like little spots with Miku merchandise?
Where they sell the merchandise has varied from venue to venue. Like in Los Angeles, they did have a pre-sale table set up outside the concert where people could buy the goods before the doors even opened. At other concert venues, like at Chicago and in New York, the merchandise booths were inside the venue. In other words, you couldn't buy anything until you actually got inside. So it's a little hard to say what will happen in Mexico until it happens. I don't have an answer for that.
Okay, dice de que no sabría muy bien cómo sería en México porque depende mucho de la zona del concierto. Algunas personas en algunos conciertos aquí en Estados Unidos hubo preventas donde la gente podía comprar las cosas que quería antes del concierto. En nuestro caso, cuando fuimos a Nueva York, no hubo preventa, así que nos tocó entrar al concierto para poder ver la mercancía. Obviamente la mercancía está en un lugar apartado del escenario. It's very apart, it's like very far away from the stage. It's not like in the stage, right?
It's not in the actual like stage area. It's gonna be probably sometime after you just get into the concert venue, in like the lobby area.
No lo vas a encontrar en el escenario, sino como bien cerquita con el lobby, como cuando apenas entras ahí es donde vas a ver la mercancía. Y si tienes alguna pregunta, simplemente pregúntale al guardia de seguridad. If you have any question, just ask, like, you know, like, where is the merchandise? That's what I did in 2014, because they had it, like, behind a door, and I was like, where is the merchandise?
Yeah, you might hear more news as the event gets closer. Or there may be signs posted around the venue, or maybe you can look through a window and you'll see everything inside. So, just keep an eye and maybe ask other people in case they know.
Yeah. Manténganse pendientes en cómo van a hacer las ventas en su ciudad. A medida que se acerque más el evento es cuando ustedes se van a dar cuenta cómo pueden comprarlo. Si antes o después del concierto. What is the best moment? This is my question. This is the best moment to get the goods, before or after the concert.
If they have pre-sales open outside before the door itself even opens, definitely getting it there is a good idea if you don't want to risk something getting sold out. Otherwise, the next best opportunity would be to get the goods after the doors open, before the concert starts, but you may not want to lose your seat, so you kind of have to decide. Do I want to get really close, or do I want to grab my some goods first before I go into the concert area? So choose wisely.
Or you can just get a friend and say, can you please hold my spot?
Or if you have friends that can help out to go buy goods while you hold a spot in line, okay.
Exactly.
But don't hold a spot for an entire crowd of people that might not make other people if they see like a crowd of like 5 to 10 people suddenly cut in line, so.
Yeah. Me pregunté en pregunta propia mía, que ¿cuál era el mejor momento para comprar la mercancía? En sí es antes del concierto, pero que si hay preventas, obviamente en la preventa es lo mejor. Do you have any Japanese friends?
Too many. I'm just not going to even try to say how many, but yes, I do.
Okay. Based on this question, what did the Japanese people say about the behavior of like the American people at the Miku concerts?
I've heard nothing regarding input from them. The Japanese fans that have come over and visited with the fans here, from what I understand and from what I've seen, what they've been saying, they've been enjoying it like the rest of us. So, but I've never really heard what their personal opinions on fans here were, with the exception of Toronto and Canada. Some of them were mad that a lot of the audience didn't want to stand and cheer with the rest of the crowd. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm. En sí, él tiene muchísimos amigos de Japón, pero hay gente que viene aquí a los conciertos y han vivido la experiencia con nosotros y simplemente la han pasado bien. Lo disfrutan al igual que nosotros, así que no ha tenido como ninguna opinión negativa respecto a nosotros. Does the image of Miku in the concert gets bad when you're very far away?
They've majorly improved on that since the first overseas concert in 2011. It's not a problem anymore.
So you can see Miku from anywhere.
You can see Miku from pretty much any angle wherever you're at. Obviously, for the best experience, you may want to be more towards the center so you can see her just kind of more easily. She doesn't really fade out, but obviously, when obviously any person goes to a far side of stage, they become harder to see. So if you're too far to one side, you may have a little harder time seeing, but she doesn't fade out like she used to.
La pregunta es de que si a medida de que la persona está más lejos de Miku, que si ella como que se distorsiona o algo por el estilo, él dice de que se arregló ese problema que había antes en los conciertos de Miku en el 2011.
In every Miku concert, do they use the same songs?
And as far as I know, for every concert within the North America Miku Expo Tour, the set list will be the same. So if you've watched too many videos or read concert set lists, you may have given yourself too many spoilers. But yes, the concerts for the North America Tour are all the same, location to location. Only exception being Seattle, because Anamanaguchi didn't have their encore song Miku ready, but from what I understand, they're not performing in Mexico, so I guess they don't have to worry about that.
Okay. Le pregunté que si las canciones son iguales para todas las expo. Él dice que sí, son para todas. Así que si tú te pones a mirar muchos videos y muchos como los setlists y todo eso, simplemente vas a llegar como cansado concierto porque no te vas a sorprender. Los casos fueron diferentes para Seattle. Fue para Seattle y tal vez México porque Anamanaguchi no va a estar ahí. Entonces los encore y la introducción va a ser diferente. Así que posiblemente tengan diferentes canciones.
There's only one band, like for all the concerts, or there are many different kind of.
It's the same band, going venue to venue. They're traveling, you know, with the crew. For the United States part of the tour, obviously, you know, they would swap out Anamanaguchi with the other band for certain sections, mainly the intro and then the encore. But since Anamanaguchi is not traveling to Mexico, it will be just the one band doing both concert locations in Mexico.
En la respuesta corta, si hay solamente una banda o si hay muchas más otras bandas, en el caso de mi juez, pues solamente una banda y es la que va a todas partes donde hay conciertos.
What is the difference between Miku Expo and any other Miku concert?
That really depends on what they mean by any other Miku concert.
I think they meant like the one that was made by Nico Nico Doga.
There was no concert event made by Nico Nico Doga, I'm sorry.
But that's what they said here.
There has been no Nico Nico Doga concert event. If there has been, they were strictly fan-made events, not official concert events.
Oh, okay.
Unless they're talking about maybe the Water concert event for the release of Project Diva F in 2012, but I think the difference between a Water-projected
concert. They are
concert
talking about the concert where Gumi, Ia, and many other.
Those are fan events, so they are in no way related to official events by Krypton, Future Media, Sega, and.
So, Miku Expo
parties
would be like the official fan.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, those other concerts they're referring to on Nico Nico were fan-made events.
En sí, esta pregunta estaba más basada a los conciertos de Nico Nico Doga, donde aparecen Gumi, Ia y todos los demás vocalos que no son Kryptonoids. Y en sí son conciertos hechos por fans, no son oficiales hechos por Krypton.
What are the benefits for being VIP at the Nico Expo?
I'm not sure if I should give the spoiler on this, so just say give a spoiler warning, skip past this if you don't want to hear what you're getting as a spoiler. But you do get a little fabric pouch bag that contains a limited green strap Miku Expo watch. You get a sticker. You get the lanyard with the VIP tag on it. And from what I understand, that's pretty much it.
Now, also, you can enter an hour before.
Oh, of course. Oh, the other benefits, not just what you get as a gift. Yes, VIP does tend to enter half an hour before the other guests do, so they also get earlier access to buying merchandise compared to other concert attendees. So
like the general admission, many people at general admission said that many stuff was sold out by the moment they got to the.
So yeah, you get to enter early, you get a little gift bag as thanks. Obviously you will get better seat as well, so Definitely worth it for those who want the best experience.
Yeah. Los de VIP van a recibir, eso es un spoiler, aunque no tanto porque yo ya subí fotos. I already post photos of the VIP package, so everything's fine. Así que van a recibir como una pequeña bolsa turquesa con un reloj turquesa, con un collar, con una tarjetita que dice VIP, con un sticker de Miku Expo. Y además pueden entrar media hora antes al concierto, lo cual les facilita estar más cerca del escenario y además pueden pueden comprar las cosas mucho mejor y mucho más fácil porque no van a tener a todo el mundo tratando de comprarlas sino solo la gente VIP. Aparte de que la vista para los VIP, yo que he sido VIP, you have been VIP, it's amazing when you're VIP.
Like,
honestly, cuando eres VIP es increíble porque lo ves ahí, ahí. Es increíble. Aparte, and also because like the Japanese fans are like around you, it's very easy to just, you know, to follow the crowd and scream with them and all that stuff. I don't know how it would be in general admission. I have never been in general admission though. So.
And that's another thing is when you're in the front and you're in the VIP, you're part of the people that's helping lead everyone else in the concert. So you also become kind of an important part of the concert as well when you're VIP.
I saw some people that were just doing whatever they want in the Miku Expo in the front. I just tried to follow like the biggest crew who's trying to lead you. Also, I saw many Japanese people who were like not right in the front, but they were like in different spots trying to lead the people. You can just spot them very easy.
I don't know how many people from Japan will be visiting in Mexico, but chances are there will be some there.
Yeah, algunos fans van a ir a México a guiarlos, pero si tú estás al frente, tú también eres parte de las personas que va a guiar las luces y todo lo demás, así que ustedes tienen que estar como acorde con los japoneses, porque ellos son los que, si quieren que se vea así de bonito, como lo ven en YouTube, que se ven las luces, que se ve todo, intenten seguir a la gente que sabe. This is gonna be a secret video, I'm going to cut it and then I'm going to upload it after Miku Expo México. As the answer, like, I'm going to have the answer later.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So, what was your favorite question